with rain, with sun, with much, with less, with dark, with much, with life, with death, all the things satisfied.
there. That song was called Everything by Chris Tomlin. He's one of my favorite worship artists, and that song fits kind of perfectly with what I want to talk to you about today. First, I want to apologize for not teaching for at least the last 6 months. There have been some things going on in my life that have kept me from the ministry. As of recently, I felt God pulling on my heart pretty strongly to come back. And there's been a recent tragedy also that has occurred in my life, and so there's been a struggle with me dealing with that. However, with God, all things are possible, and I know He will see me and my family through this time, and we'll all come out stronger and better on the other side. So, what I want to talk to you about today is, what is the point of all of this? You know, why minister? What's the point of God? What's the point of anything, really? What's the point of the universe? What's the point of living? You know? That has been the question that has been on my mind for at least, let's just say my whole life. I've never really understood what the point of all of this was. Like, why? Am I going to answer for certain the all-encompassing question of why are we all here? No, because unfortunately, I don't have that answer. But through my own journey, I've come up with a few definitions and a few answers to a few questions that I hope will help you maybe try to understand the point of some of the experiences that we have every day, spirituality, God, universe. And so there's no scripture in this presentation. This is just me speaking about life and experiences and my definitions of how I see things. And I hope that you find some comfort and some God and some spirituality as we move forward. So God bless, and thank you for joining me. So the point is, like I said, we're going to talk about God and spirituality, and what's the point of them? What does a human being need with God and spirituality? Why do we do it? Why do we even worry about what God is? As you all know, there's probably quite a few theories out there about God and spirituality. If you notice, the background for the presentation that I'm using this time is universe and stars and planets. The reason for that is one of the theories, and this is, you know, one of the most popular theories right now. You see it all over the History Channel. I'm sure many of you have watched Ancient Aliens. I know I did. I watched it, you know, straight through season one through whatever season they're on now. Because the theory itself is very interesting. The problem with any theory is that it can't be proven. And the remaining question, you know, even if the aliens were the ones that caused the genetic mutation that caused the human race to be what it is now, so what? You still have the question of, how'd the aliens get there? Who made them? And so, you end up with this long string of problems. If aliens made humans, then another alien race must have made that alien race, and then another alien race made that alien race, and so on and so forth. You get my point. Somewhere along the line, there has to be an origin. There has to be an origin somewhere along the line. Now, in science, they've actually found what most physics, what most people in the physics community believe to be the God particle. It's called the Higgs boson, I think is what it's called, particle. And what they're saying is that essentially they can trace the universe back to before the universe existed, right? So you have, and they got, then they found this particle by smashing atoms together, and then this particle appeared and, you know, proved the Big Bang. Okay, no problem, I get it. So the theory is, they say that the universe was nothing but swirling gases and had no mass of any kind, and then all of a sudden there's this particle that appears and explodes and causes mass to appear out of nothing, of gases and, you know, what have you. I see a lot of holes in that. And the number one hole being, where'd the particle come from? Again, there has to be origin. When you think about things logically and with reason and get your head out of the clouds, so to speak, logic and reason lead to there has to be a starting point. There has to be origin. Things don't just appear out of nothing. Right? Which is why human beings naturally seek something outside of themselves. There is something innate within the human psyche that we know we didn't just appear here out of nothing. We didn't come from a monkey. We didn't come from a blade of grass. You know, we might have all been made and constructed out of the same stuff, the Bible says. We were created out of the dust of the earth, which is also the same dust in the stars in the sky. That doesn't mean that we weren't created just because we're all made out of stardust. So what? There still has to be origin. Think about it logically, and you'll, I'm sure, come to the same conclusion. What made the Higgs boson particle? What caused the explosion? Who knows? Something had to. And it wasn't the particle itself, because that particle didn't appear out of nothing. Something had to have made it. Okay, so there's that rant. Moving on. So what's the point of God and spirituality? Well, first of all, we need to answer the question, what is God? This is my definition. This isn't taken from a book. This is my definition and my personal journey, my personal experience. This is what God is to me. So I'm just going to go ahead and read it to you. God is the all-encompassing spirit of the universe, responsible for the design, creation, and intelligence of every living creature in the universe, both known and unknown. See? I covered all the alien species there that we don't even know about, okay? God is the all-encompassing spirit of the universe. It's the thing that we all try to tap into. It's the thing that Buddhists try to get to when they meditate, even though they say they don't believe in God. I was a Buddhist. I did meditate. I practiced meditation for over a decade, trying to find this thing that everybody called God, okay? And it wasn't until I became a Christian and found Jesus, and I know that sounds so cliche, but seriously, there's a verse in the Bible that says, no one comes to the Father but through me. And I believe that that is absolutely true, because people will seek and seek and seek and seek and seek God and never find this all-encompassing spirit of the universe, and never have the absolute peace and love within themselves that you have when you meet Jesus for the first time and actually accept him as part of your life. Now, God does mean different things to different people, but I think this definition can pretty much apply to everyone. If you use your logic and use your reason, you have to know that there is something, maybe not someone, but something that our human minds cannot even comprehend out there that is the origin of everything. And that is God. Okay? So that is my definition of what God is. Next, we need to know, well, okay, we have God, but what the heck is spirituality? Well, spirituality, and this again is my definition, I did not take this out of a book. Spirituality is the heartfelt, mind-guided, soul-led practice of seeking and eventually finding God. Does that make sense to everyone? I hope so. Spirituality is something that you feel in your heart, is guided with your mind, but is led by your soul. We all have a soul, and within that soul is the natural need that creates the God part of our brain, I guess I should say, that causes us to naturally seek out something outside of ourselves to explain the reason why we're here. Everybody does this. There's not one human being on this planet that does not seek out a reason to live. And I think this is the most difficult part of being a human being. Plants, okay, they come from a seed. The plant already knows what it's supposed to be. The tree already knows what it's supposed to be. A cat knows it's a cat, and it does what cats do. A dog knows it's a dog, and it does what dogs do. The same with every other animal on this planet. They know what they are. They naturally do what God put them here to do. The problem with being human is that we're so much more intelligent. We have a more complex brain. And therefore, at least in my life, we overthink our lives to such an extent that we completely miss the purpose that we have to be here. We completely miss the point of our very existence. We wind up believing that we're here to do something mundane, like write a song or, you know, work in customer service. Guys and girls, I'm gonna tell you right now, your purpose in this life, your reason for existing, has absolutely nothing to do with anything outside of yourself. Okay? You're looking at your purpose right now. Spirituality is one purpose that you have, which is to feel in your heart, let your mind guide you, your soul lead you in the seeking and finding of God. We're going to get to why in a few minutes, so stay with me here. A few questions for you to consider. Number one, can one have spirituality without God? Number two, can one have God without spirituality? Number three, must one be religious in order to be spiritual and have God in his or her life. I'm wondering how many different answers all of you have given to those questions in your mind as we go along. I'm sure the answer to the first one was yes, that you can be spiritual without God. And I'm sure the answer to number three, possibly, especially if you're not a Christian, was also yes. Because many people that are not Christian, who see a lot of, as I like to call them, fake Christians these days, view them as religious. And we'll get to what my definition of religious is later. And they think the terms spirituality and religious go hand in hand and basically mean the same thing. I'm going to tell you, they do not mean the same thing. So, what are the answers to these three questions? No! They all have the same answer. You cannot have spirituality without God, and you cannot have God without spirituality. It doesn't matter what religion you are, okay? It doesn't matter if you're Buddhist, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Taoist. It absolutely makes no difference what religion you happen to be. You are still seeking the all-encompassing spirit of the universe, which is God. If you have a religion, you automatically have spirituality, and you're automatically seeking God. Okay? And my other point that I want to make about this, when it comes to being is that being religious is not the same thing as spirituality, okay? So my definition of religious, what is religious? To me, religious is a person or one who carries a holier-than-thou attitude, holds and makes willful judgments on others, who is without meekness, is not humble, and is prideful because he or she has, quotation marks, God. Now just sit with that for a minute. How many Christians have you met that are exactly that definition? Who think they're above other people, who walk around as if, you know, nothing can touch them, and there's this arrogance and this pride coming off of them like they are just, you know, God's gift to the world. When in fact, they're God's gift to himself, not anybody else. We were created by God simply for his pleasure. Nothing else. Okay? This pridefulness that these, as I like to call them, religious people have, and you can find religious people in any religion. It's not just Christianity. You can find this in Muslims, Taoists, Buddhists. You're just going to. Pride does not care what religion you are. It can sneak up on anybody and cause them to make themselves believe that they are above someone else in any kind of way. And once you look at yourself as being better than another person because they don't have what you have, whether that thing you have is spiritual or mundane, doesn't matter. Your attitude will be the same. And once you have that attitude, it's extremely difficult to break it. So am I better than any of these people that I call religious? Absolutely not. Do I pray for them every day? Yes. What do I pray? That God's will be done in their life. The same that I want God's will to be done in my life. And that pride, if I am being prideful, is removed from me. And if they are being prideful, that it's removed from them. And that all judgments be held for God and for no one else. Big difference between spirituality and religious. So next time someone says, "Ooh, you're religious," you know, you can say, "No, I'm spiritual, and these are the definitions." Feel free to use the definitions of spiritual, God, and religious from this video in your own personal life if you need them to defend yourself, okay? It's not a problem. Do spirituality and God require religion? No. Okay, so get to it already. What is the point that I'm trying to make? What is the point of religion? What is the point of spirituality? What is the point of seeking and eventually finding God? Why do we do this? Why? What's the point of all of it? What is wrong with a human being that all we do is seek God through spirituality? What do we need? What are we trying to get to? The answer to that question is unbelievably simple. Okay? You ready? Okay, here it comes. Here's your answer. Peace and love. All we ever want as human beings is to love and be loved and have peace. And we don't have peace until we're content and happy with our lives. And we don't get happy with our lives until we find out what our purpose is and what we're supposed to be doing with ourselves. This is why the Bible says you seek God first in all things. Why? Because if you do that, you get peace and love in your life. It comes automatically. And then everything that you do outside of yourself, with the mundane world, going to work, whatever, none of that seems as important anymore. Because you've realized that your purpose has nothing to do with the world. You might be a famous singer. You might be a famous author. You might be, you know, just regular old Joe Schmo, you know, walking down the street. But if you seek God as you're walking down the street, guess what? You have peace in your heart and love in your heart. And once you have peace and love, that hole that you have inside of you is filled. It's not gaping open. It's not gaping open anymore. Let God fill that hole for you. All of us have it. We're born with it. That's why we seek out God. We're born with a natural inclination to seek God. And no matter what we try to fill that hole with outside of ourselves, money, cars, houses, kids, husbands, boyfriends, girlfriends, none of that matters. None of that will satisfy you. None of that will provide you the true peace and the true love that the all-encompassing spirit of the universe can provide for you. In all things, in all aspects of your life. Seek God. And eventually, you will find that all-encompassing spirit of the universe. That hole in your soul, the hole in your heart, will be filled. And then you won't need all those other things. You won't need the drugs. You won't need the alcohol. You won't need the cigarettes. You won't need the sex. You won't need all of those unhealthy things. Food for some people. And you won't live a life of depression and heartache. Because the peace and love of God is in you. And that's what we're here to find. Peace and love. And that peace and love is from God. God bless all of you. I love all of you. Thank you for listening.